open my hood up too.
No, don't do that. You're not allowed to. What's up, everybody? What the fuck is up, everybody? Anna, you're not allowed to do that, bro. Not allowed to do that. Wow, and you know what I just noticed? I'm way out of frame. Way out of frame. So,
what the fuck is
Anna,
this?
Introduce yourself. Let people know what's up.
Okay. Hey, guys. My name's Anna. Welcome to the From Earth podcast. We are broadcasting live from Earth. Wow, my hair does not fit in this hood. It's not working out. This isn't going to happen. Today, on today's podcast, I'm struggling here. Me and Gilmar are wearing matching hoodies. Woo! No.
Wow, my hair is fucked up.
Matching hoodies.
I just showered. So
Gilmar
crazy.
Actually ordered by accident two of these hoodies and they were on sale, so he can't return them. So RIP his bank account. Congratulations to me for getting a new hoodie out of it.
Yeah, hoodies are actually pretty fire though.
Yes,
they're like
nice.
Bedazzled.
The fit is nice. Pretty sick. I feel like I bedazzled this myself like when I was in like eighth grade. I don't know.
Yeah, but it's not like, all right, so I'm gonna jump right into it. It's not like I bought this for us like to match, because first of all, you in high school or something, dog?
Yeah, I think it would be cute to match. I mean, we do have matching underwear.
People who do that, it's like, yeah, but that's different. No one sees that. Only you and I see that.
So are you embarrassed to match with me?
No, I'm just saying like this.
We also have matching pajamas.
Oh, fuck. Look at my hair.
Yeah, it looks stupid. Bruh, y'all know that.
I need a fucking haircut.
I already explained to them that you didn't do it intentionally to match, that you accidentally bought it and it was on sale so you couldn't return it.
Yeah, it was like, I was like, fuck, I maybe done fucked up.
You did done fucked up.
But, because what happened was, so I was at Wendy's. My brother and I were at Wendy's, and I think it was before we went to watch a movie, and Paxton was having a sale, and I was like, yo, I'm gonna cop these. So then, which by the way, it took like a month for them to get here. But anyway, I bought two. I went to check out first, and then it didn't, like, it said my card didn't go through. So I was like, what the fuck? So then I tried again later, and it went through. And then next thing you know, two packages coming to my doorstep. I didn't check my email like quick enough to see that it got ordered twice, because I didn't think that would have happened. So then it like finally showed up and there was like two packages. I'm like, what the fuck? Did they send me something for free? And then I saw that it got ordered twice, and yeah, pretty shitty.
I think you could have called them and explained to them what happened.
Yeah.
And they probably would have let you return it. But at this point, it's too late.
Yeah, you have it on.
So I have it on my body. And I asked you, I said, you know, is it okay if I do this first? And you said yes. So.
Yeah, true. I did say yes.
Yeah, so you did authorize me to do that.
But I took the strings out just because.
Should I take my strings out?
Nah, you don't have to do that. You're white. Just kidding. I don't know. I don't like having the strings in my hoodies anymore.
I don't use them.
I think. I mean, I could use it in this instance right now, so I could tie this up, and then it wouldn't be falling off, but, you know.
I don't use them. I never use my hoodie strings.
Yeah, same.
Like, I don't think I ever have. Maybe, like, as a joke.
I think Fear of God got me stuck onto that, just because Jerry doesn't really put strings on his hoodies, so I just like the look. It just looks so clean.
It looks
really nice.
Yeah.
So,
and what's really like the point? Like, do people really like use them, or is it just for like the?
No, people use them. Like, again,
guys,
people use them so the hoodie can stay like tied like this.
Hoodie podcast 2019. We're going to discuss all of our favorite features of hoodies, and
it's our new segment, Hoodie Cast, where we talk about hoodies.
Honestly, though,
that's very loud.
Hoodies are one of my favorite pieces of articles of clothing.
Mm-hmm.
They're just really like,
they're comfy, man.
Yeah, they just bring me to another level of comfort and happiness that maybe I wouldn't have achieved otherwise.
I'd be chilling. I'd be chilling in a hoodie.
I'd be chilling. True. Facts. And that's on period.
No. Facts only though.
That's on a period.
No, facts only though. But yeah, I'd be chilling hard as fuck in a hoodie. Oh, Jesus. But
Sorry. Talking
about couples that match, annoying couples, yo, I've been seeing some
I'm dying.
I've been seeing some dumb shit lately.
Yeah, looking in the mirror.
Ha, what the fuck, Dan? I got fucking flame, boy.
Yeah, you fucking did.
I don't know if I'm going to recover from that. I might have to go to an AA meeting or something. I'm going to start doing meth. Anyway.
Sorry, guys. We've been watching Breaking Bad. And
wow, we're just all over the
this
place.
This is going to be a meth-themed podcast. Mm. Just kidding. So you were saying something. I forget now.
Methamphetatheme, am I right?
Methamphetatheme? What the fuck?
Get at me, boy.
Yo.
No, but
there's a lot of money.
So I've been seeing some people, like, do you know what a simp is?
No.
So actually, I don't know the exact definition of it, but I have an idea of it. So I'm just gonna look it up. Simp, plural simp, a man who foolishly overvalues a woman and puts her on a pedestal. A simple person lacking common sense, foolish simpleton. So I've been seeing a lot of simps lately. And like on social media. And this is one of the main reasons why I don't like social media.
And let's just preface this by saying that, you know, it's good to be good to your
woman,
female significant other,
to your companion, or just, you know,
or just your significant other in general. Yeah. But there is a certain level of like whining. You know what I mean? Like guys that are whiny about it, or
just guys that are like, no, man, just like, bro, this is some shit high schoolers do. You're a grown man. What you doing?
Because high schoolers are whiny in their relationships. And by whiny, I mean like the guys that... And you know what? People don't even have to be in a relationship to display this stupid behavior.
Yeah, very true.
Like a lot of guys will be like, oh, mom, or whatever. I don't know. I don't
like,
know
my mom's my
saying.
World. She's my rock. I'd do anything for my mom.
And like, okay,
like,
true.
All right, we get it.
But yeah, the incessant advertisement of that is like, you're just trying to get girls.
Fuck your mom, you know?
Okay.
Relax.
Does your mom watch this?
Nah.
All right, then yeah, fuck your mom.
Yeah, fuck your
just
mom,
do
bro.
It.
Just slip in her DMs. Is that easy?
I've watched porn like that, you know? It's fine.
And I love my mom, but I don't be putting that shit out there like 24/7.
Yeah. I love my mom. My mom is my world.
Yeah, it's just an example I thought of. But like,
chill out.
The main example I've been seeing is like dudes with girls like, oh my gosh, she's so beautiful. I wish like I want to be there and love you and shit.
You said shit like that to me.
Yeah, but I ain't posting on social media. You know, I kept that. That's between
us.
Yeah,
no, true. That's between
but
us.
But it's like people are you putting that shit on. Like, yo, what? What are you
like,
doing?
It's cool to like upload a picture of your girl and be like, love this bitch. Well, you don't even have to say something like that.
Yeah.
You can literally be like, I love her.
But if you guys are posting your intimate conversations, it's like, what are you doing?
Yeah. How do
What's
I turn down
for?
The volume in my headphones? Like this is loud.
You're like trying to get a...
Thank you.
Trying to get some likes. You're trying to get other girls to be like, oh my God, I wish I had a boy like
yeah,
him.
Yeah, well, most of the people that are doing that don't even have a significant other. He's just trying to get girls by being like that.
Can girls do the same thing? Can girls also be simps?
It's there. No.
Well, I think
there's
think
like a
they
different.
Can.
They can, but I think you
because
see.
Because those girls that be like, when my man come home, I bust it over him, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, true, but.
I'm a cook for him, suck his dick, and treat him right. Like, oh, relax,
yeah,
Stefania. What the fuck is that about? I don't know.
Yeah, no, that shit's like crazy.
Yeah, I don't know. Simps are annoying as shit. I've been seeing that a lot lately on the internet, and I'm like,
what's the Urban Dictionary definition of a simp?
A simp is a crybaby who can't get pussy no matter how hard he tries. A simp will go and offer a shoulder to cry on or really nice to a woman. Yeah, that's exactly.
A better definition. Yeah, yeah.
But it's like...
Settle down,
bro. It's all good. You'll find that person someday.
Can I bitch about my dreads for 5 seconds?
Okay.
I took a shower last night and they're still wet. Done.
Nice.
I just thought I'd let everybody know that.
Nice. Yeah, fuck
that's
dreads.
Like the worst part of having dreads
shake
is that
dreads,
I will wash my dreads and they will be wet for years. And it's super annoying.
That's what you get, bro.
Fuck you.
No. But
I'm gonna dread your hair tonight. Overnight.
How could you
I'm gonna buy synthetic ones or real ones, doesn't matter, and I'm gonna install them.
That's kind of fucked up.
Yeah, I don't give a fuck.
I didn't expect that from you, out of all people.
I don't give a fuck.
But anyway, talking about stupid shit on social media. Another stupid thing is like stupid YouTube videos. Like, I swear to God, because I brought this up because Cody Ko just did a video on the Dobre brothers. Well, one of the Dobre brothers.
God.
And he had this video about him like crashing his girlfriend's McLaren into his other supercar. And it's like, the video is just so fucking stupid. Like,
it's bad. It's top tier bad.
Yeah, like if you guys want to know more about that, go on YouTube, look up Cody Ko, car crash, not a prank or something like that. And he basically lays it out perfectly. But that made me want to talk about just like dumb YouTube channels.
I feel like I don't even know what to say about it because I don't watch that stuff.
I don't either, but I watch people that talk about that stuff.
Yeah, same.
And I always see thumbnails, like they're always like trending for some reason. Stupid ass shit.
Yeah.
But it's like I'm about to run a stupid channel and make millions, bro. You and I should just like start making videos that make no fucking sense.
Start pranking each other. Didn't we talk about pranks last time?
I think so. We talked about this a little bit.
So that,
but it's like even like their regular vlog videos suck.
Yeah, if you thought that the pranking was the worst thing you've seen, you don't even know.
Yeah, like
you don't even know.
Like they have like how do they come up with this?
I don't know. Like that car crash video was literally not. He was like, this is not a prank. And he just crashed into his girlfriend's car.
And then it's like,
and then he was like, yeah, baby, I did it for YouTube. And she was like, what?
And it's like, why are you making these videos?
Yeah.
Like, bro, you're probably laying down like, you know what would be cool? If I crash your car into my car.
But you know who those videos are for. And I think Cody Ko addresses this in his videos.
Like, yeah, this is why I don't want to use this video as an example. But they are for kids. But what I'm saying is, at the end of the day, it's still dumbass. Like, bro, the fact that that's even scarier, that it's not for us, that it's for kids. And kids can't see past that bullshit. And they're being fed this stupid that's entertainment true. That makes no sense. And it's not going to help them in any way, shape, or form.
That's true. That's but just going to help them the only form thing that's gonna, opinions that are
And the
wrong
only thing
about
that
the
they're going to get out of this is like, go crash a car into someone. It's funny.
Yeah, like they're just forming
what
wrong.
What the fuck, bro?
Yeah, wrong opinions about the world.
And not only that, but not everyone has a fucking McLaren and yeah, another too. Crazy race car. Like, our kids just going to be normalized to seeing this shit and be
yeah,
like
everybody just has these kind of cars.
Yeah, it's like, what the fuck? Like, I don't know.
How do you think that guy affords those cars?
By making stupid fucking videos like that.
But
that shit has millions of views. And not
does
only
really?
That, but they also have a channel with their brothers, like the all Dobre, right. whatever the
I
fuck.
I want to see how much the Dobre brothers, how many views they
Dude,
get.
Dude, they have millions of views, like millions of subscribers. And do your thing, man. Get your bag. But like, what the fuck, man? These kids, man.
Oh, wow. They have 8 million subscribers.
Yeah.
Their video that they put up 3 days ago is called Our Girlfriends Broke Up With Us. And there's a bunch of like hot girls in the thumbnail. So of course that's going to get like mad views. And then them looking sad.
You and I should break up.
Oh my God, these are horrible. He hypnotized me to fall in love with him. Our girlfriends knocked each other out. I asked my brother's wife to marry me. An alien is growing inside my wife.
Oh my God.
Secretly putting foods on college students' heads in library. Oh my God. Giant snake revenge prank on girlfriend. My wife meets my ex-girlfriend. Oh my God. Oh my God. This video has 7.7 million views. And it's called Our Girlfriends Pranked Us for 24 Hours.
Yo, imagine getting pranked for 24 hours straight and not seeing it coming. Look, oh, I just got pranked. I hope it doesn't happen again.
Ah, every fucking 5 minutes.
Ah. 5 minutes later, oh shit, I got pranked again. Oh my God. Like, what the fuck, bro?
So
hey, is this Home Alone, bro? Are you guys just fucking, like, Jesus Christ, man.
The second most popular video on their YouTube has 23 million views. I hate that so much. And it's called Switching Girlfriends for 24 Hours. And you know every 12-year-old boy wanted to watch that video.
Yeah, for real. I don't know,
anyway,
man. That shit's just like,
it's wild. That's some wild-ass shit,
and there's
man.
There's some like worse shit than that. Like, even true. Like those, remember when like the Elsa and
I was
Spider-Man.
Just going to say the Spider-Man and Elsa
yeah,
videos.
Like, that was really bad.
What even were those? I never watched them or understood what the point was.
It was just people.
Like, what was Spider-Man and Elsa doing in the videos?
Nothing. Literally nothing. It was just a generate views, and you know kids were gonna, I was hot at the time, so kids were gonna watch Spider-Man and Elsa. Like, honestly, they did nothing. Well, didn't Ethan Bradbury and them make those
videos? I think so, yeah. And they made like a killing off of them. I remember Ethan Klein talking about those videos. That's the only reason I know about them, but I can't like remember what the point of them was or what even happened.
What even transpired at all.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was just a bunch of weird shit.
I wonder if they're still getting views. Hold on. Let's just look up the Spider-Man and Elsa shit and see if that's still going on.
They probably still are getting views from all that.
Especially because Frozen 2 or whatever is coming out.
Oh, yeah.
You want to know something gross about Frozen 2?
What?
There's already, like, porn for it.
Nice.
The only reason I know... Can I admit that I watch porn so I can explain that something?
I don't care.
If you go on Pornhub right now, one of the most searched things is Frozen 2. It's disturbing.
That's crazy as fuck.
Because I clicked in the search thing, and it was, like, they show all, like, the trending searches, and that's, like, one of the most popular ones right now.
Oh, my God.
And bro. I was like... Fuck. So I clicked on it for 5 seconds just to see what the fuck was going on, and it was disturbing, and I was like, I gotta get the fuck out of here.
Yo, people need to chill out, man.
Yo, people really do need to chill out. Like, dude, I can't even explain how disturbed I was by that.
Yeah, I've never watched porn, so I don't know what that's like. Super weird, right?
There's all kinds of these videos.
Yeah, there's a lot of dumb fucking videos, man.
Oh my God.
But how about we just make a toy review channel? I got really cute nephews.
How about we make some Frozen 2 porn?
Sure, but what? No, I'm not saying sure to that.
Wait, who was it that did these with Bradbury?
I'm Ethan Bradbury.
Yeah, it looks like the only videos that are still like the Bradbury, they don't have it anymore that I can find.
All right, well, I'm done with that.
Yeah. Okay, me too.
But yeah, those...
So let's talk more about porn. No, I'm just kidding. Oh my God, wait, I want to do a quick shout out.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out Sarah and Richie. That's my sister and her boyfriend. They binge watched, apparently, some of our episodes like a week ago or something. So anyway, if y'all are watching, I know y'all are high as fuck.
I know y'all watch porn.
I know y'all had a drink. We know y'all watching porn. Just kidding. I don't know. Watch porn. Do whatever you want.
Yeah, man.
It's a weird conversation with my sister. Anyway, yeah. So shout out y'all for just being you.
For being you. And shout out to my dad for leaving me when I was 13. I'm a better man because of it. I look up to rappers as father figures.
Can you name the best father figure rapper, you think? Like 6ix9ine or whatever his name is?
I would say Bobby Shmurda.
Isn't he like in jail?
Oh no, wait, Hurricane Chris.
I don't even know who that is.
Hey baby.
Oh, I know who that is.
That's what I had to say. So recently I shot
a man. You just sounded like you were going to mention
Could you that. Not?
All right, my bad. It's not my fault that, you know, what you do is not my fault.
Going to have to fix that in post.
All right. Well, last time I mentioned something, you left it in, so. All right, anyway, so you shot, what'd you shoot? Who'd you shoot? I mean, what? Did you shoot? Where?
Shot an event.
An event. Is that his last name?
No, I went to shoot an event. It was a girl's 15. She was turning 15. And
yo, you shot up an event?
Sofia Quinceañera. Oh, that's not funny.
Oh my God, it's not funny.
Please,
at
nobody
all.
Shoot
that's
up any events.
So sad. All right. Sorry, everybody.
R.I.P. No, I shot for an event and I killed it. So now. My friend Josue was like, yo, it was like a last minute thing. He's like, can you go take photos, be a photographer for this quinceañera? I was like, yeah, bet, I'm down. So then I showed up and yo, everyone there was really cool.
Everyone there was really scared of me. It was probably my gun.
Some people tried to tackle me. Like, what are you doing, bro?
That's cool though. Yeah, the pictures were pretty. It looked like a really fun time.
Yo, it was actually, it was like really good time. Everyone's having fun. There was good music being played. I like showed up and I was like, you know, I was trying to be comfortable, this and that. And as soon as I walked in, I saw like my friend's parents, my friend Hector, his mom and dad were there. I was like, oh shit, like I haven't seen him in years. Like, yo, what's up? And then his mom did all the decorations. They came out really nice. And I was like, I'll tell him I said hi. So I was like, all right, there's some people here that I might know. And then everyone that I saw there, I didn't know. But the DJ, I knew him because I used to DJ with the guys that he hangs around with now. So shout out Freddie and Goff. You know, they taught me almost everything I know about DJing. But yeah, I saw really him there, cool. So that was pretty cool. And then, like, they were giving out drinks and shit. And then I didn't want to drink because I wanted to be professional. But the guy that contracted me, his name's Alex. Shout out Alex. Yo, he's a real cool dude. He has a cafe called Cafe Ojalá. It's in the little farmer's market by the Halo Farm. So if you guys can, check it out. It's really nice. They have great fucking coffee. Great. He gave me an avocado toast sandwich with, like, egg on it. So fucking good. Really good. And I had it with some truffle hot sauce.
Yo, I do want to go there.
Bro. Yeah, we should go.
Yeah.
It's a really, really nice spot. And it's real chill.
I wish they were like they had a bigger spot so I could like go there and do homework.
Yeah, they have like a small table, and then you know, it's kind of like grab and go, but yeah. You can also hang out there. He's a really cool guy to talk to. There's a lot of nice artwork on the walls.
That's sick.
And yeah, but he does more than just like bread and coffee. Like there's like empanadas and different stuff that his mom makes. Like a lot of Puerto Rican recipes. It's really cool.
That's really cool.
But anyway, so he came up to me. He's like, yo, you know, you can go grab a drink, right? Like, it's cool. I was like, yeah, I'm just trying to be professional. He's like, nah, go ahead, man. He's like, yo, to be honest, we don't care. I was like, all right, but, you know, in the back of my head, I was like, I got to drive, so I'm not trying to get too lit.
Anyway, so Gilmar drove drunk that night. No, just kidding.
I hit three deers and half a child. Anyway.
Half?
Yeah, he was running across the street. I was only able to get half his body. But anyway.
Okay. Probably so, shouldn't. Talk about Shut running up. Kids over. Okay.
Aww, I'm not kids. Gonna tell. Stop incriminating me.
Sorry, my bad.
I'm just gonna say something and we move past it, all right?
All right, fine.
Say something.
Move past it?
That's right.
Okay, all right. Okay, move past
it. Just breathe in, breathe out. It's easy. It's cool. All right. So then, I went and got a drink, right? And then I saw there was a little tip jar. And the bartender was there. So I was like, all right, you know, I'm going to give him a tip. And I only had like $1 cash. So I was like, all right, I'm going to give him this $1 cash. I only got one. So I tipped him. He's like, thank you very much. He's like, thank you. I got myself a little rum and coke. And then I drank it, right? And I was like, fuck. I tipped him when I had a drink, right? And usually when you first tip someone, especially if it's a dollar, and you go up and get another drink, doesn't that kind of mean you have to tip him again, right?
Yeah.
So I didn't have any more cash. So I was like, I don't think I can get another drink. Like, I'm like, fuck, I don't have any more money to give him. So am I just supposed to like,
well, so
not get a drink?
Like, it's kind of hard to know what you're supposed to do in that situation because oftentimes they're making a gratuity from the party. So they're getting, he's probably getting like $100 maybe from the party just in general. But it is kind of customary to tip on top of that.
Yeah, right.
I usually throw, and I learned this from my dad, if in the beginning of the night, you tip them like $5-$10, and then that way, the next couple times you come back, they don't really expect much. What my dad does is he gives them a 20, and then he's like, take care of me, because he's a weirdo.
Yeah, that's why I fucked up, because
you fucked up.
I should have waited until my second drink to give him the dollar tip. Because then I would have been like, all right, I'm good. I had two drinks.
Yeah. Are you paying for the drinks at all?
No.
If you're not paying for the drinks, I don't think it's customary to tip.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, I think that a lot of people do, but I don't think that anyone would look at you and be like, wow, he didn't tip if you're not paying for it. Because that means that he's probably making a larger gratuity from the...
Fuck. But either way, it still would have felt weird because I had gave him a dollar. And then the next time I went up, I didn't have no money. And I would have been like, it just would have felt weird.
Yeah, it would have felt weird.
So because of that, I didn't drink anymore. I was like, fuck, like,
yeah,
I'm going to feel weird.
It's probably a good thing.
it's probably a good thing. Like, one drink didn't do anything to me because I'm fucking, man, I'm a grown ass man. But I was like, two drinks would have been cool. But I wasn't able to have a second one because I would have felt weird about tipping him the first time and then going back.
Yeah.
And then not tipping him.
Yeah.
So I was like, damn, I fucked up.
You did fuck up.
But overall, it was a really cool event. It was, yo, they got lit. They were, at one point, they all started jumping. A lot of people were jumping for the songs. And I felt the ground, like,
oh, stop.
Shaking. I was like, yo, this shit's going to cave in, bro. But But that house was old. It was in the Sand Gardens. They had like this little house.
Yeah, I've walked past that.
Yo, I didn't know people do parties in there.
Yeah.
It's a nice space. It's cool.
I like, figured people did parties in there, but I've never like thought about, I don't know. Mm. I've never seen anybody doing a party in there. I think I saw someone do a wedding in Sand Gardens and they went back to that little place.
Yeah, I can see that happening.
Yeah.
It was a dope spot. There was like enough room for people to dance. Like everyone had a spot to sit. They laid it out really well. And the food was good. The food is really good. I had a roast beef, bro. I should have got more.
Damn.
But I was like, nah, I'm gonna be nice about this. You know, it's not my party.
You're not gonna eat all the food.
Yeah, I'm not gonna be all greedy because trust me, if it was like my cousin's party or something, bro, I would have been in there.
You would have fucked that shit up.
Bro, I would have been fucked that shit up.
You look through like the pictures you took. Look at my hair.
What
the
fuck's going on? I look like I'm in the band Good Charlotte or some shit.
Yo, what is going on with your hair, man? What you doing?
I don't know, man.
Put your hood up. Nobody wants to see that shit. No, I'm just kidding. You look fine. I love you so much. I'm sorry. But you look through your pictures for the event, and half of them are of like the food. You're like, fuck.
Like, fuck. Yo, I'm gonna put my headphones over the hoodie, bro.
Damn, you look like a fucking scumbag.
You can't tell me shit,
boy. You look like a scumbag.
I look a scumbag, but it's all good.
Hold on.
Deep down inside, I know who I am. What are you doing? What are you doing? This is racist. This is racist.
I was just trying to kill you.
That's racist.
I was trying to strangle you to death. Is there something wrong with that?
This is racist.
Should I not be fucking trying to strangle you to death?
How was that? But
fuck you.
But I like taking photos for events because I meet new people, and like that, just that one event, like got me to meet this guy Alex, which got me to meet two more people that are creatives also in Trenton, which is really fucking cool. Shout out Naj. She was cool as fuck. I also showed them some videos on our, I showed, Naj and this other guy that was there. I'm so sorry. I forgot your name. But he followed me on Instagram. And he looks Spanish, but he looks just Latino, but he told me that, his parents are from like Bangladesh. And I think one of his parents is Bangladesh and the other one's white. And I was like, oh shit. Like, bro, mm-hmm. you look like Latino or something. Mm-hmm. He's like, yeah, I get that a lot. But shout out to them. They're actually really cool. And they both shoot on film, which is something I want to get into. They shoot film photography. But they're really creative, and their Instagrams look really cool. And Naj was telling me she wanted to do a podcast. Like, she wanted to start one up. But I was like, bro, I have one. You should come through, and we can have her on the podcast, and she can tell a story, you know.
Come through. I got a sick mustache. Come through.
She's also an optometrist, so Anna could probably be like, she could be like, yo, what's wrong with my eyes?
Retinas?
Yeah, fix my retinas, boy.
Yo, girl, my retina's about to fall out. What you going to do about it?
Nothing. Nothing.
What you going to do about my retinas?
Nothing.
Yo, fix my retinas. Oh, no.
Ew, what is that?
That's it's like my mustache.
Hulk Hogan's handlebar mustache. Like the Fu Manchu.
Would you still want to be with me if I had a mustache like this?
I'd question it. I'd be like, why? And also, if it was like that black, like if you're, because you have blonde hair, you're white.
I'm a white.
Yo, if you had dark hair, you'd look weird.
Really? Should I dye my hair black?
Don't do that.
I've always wanted to see what I would look like with black hair, just for like 1 second.
I think you'd look evil.
Maybe I want to look evil.
Because I think you just naturally look like, you have like an angel face. Dr. Angel face. Dr. Angel face. So I feel like if you had black hair, you'd look like evil.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I kind of want that for myself.
Why?
I want you to be scared of me.
I don't want to be scared of you, and it's not possible.
I don't care about what you... Did I say that I cared about what you wanted?
Did I stutter?
Did I fucking stutter? No, I want you to be scared of me. I want you to live in fear in your own home.
Oh my God.
Just kidding.
I'm good off that.
Yeah.
I'm good off that, Ma.
Speaking of being scared in your own home, recently me and Gilmar had Gerard over, and he started playing The Last of Us on our PS4, which he's never played before. And both me and Gilmar I played it once, like right after high school, when it first came out. Too. And then we played it through together.
That's kind of how Anna and I bonded when we first met a little bit.
Yeah, a little bit of that was us playing The Last of Us, which is crazy.
It's a great fucking game. I'll say
definitely,
that.
Definitely, I would have to say, I mean, I don't know, I kind of go between that and Skyrim, but those are like top two favorite video games of all times. Those are, like, the only two games I've ever actually, like, played all the way through, like, the storyline. Like, I feel like I get bored of video games pretty quickly, but those two I, like, spent a lot of time. A lot of time. Did that stop recording? Oh, my God.
So much time.
Wow. Weird. Yeah, big fan. So, anyway, the point is that we started watching Gerardo playing it, and then I always get obsessed with it, so I watch, like, playthroughs on YouTube. And then I found out that there is an official release date, which I didn't know about.
I didn't know about that either.
Yeah, I'm sure we're super late in the times, but apparently it's coming out, like, May.
May 5th, I think.
May 5th.
Cinco de Mayo. 2020.
Very excited to get it. Super excited to play through it. Honestly, like, I can't wait. Like, I cannot wait. It's going to be so good.
Yeah, I'm gonna go ham, bro.
I'm really excited to feel really emotional.
Yeah, Anna always almost always cried at the beginning of The Last of Us.
Shut the fuck up.
So,
dude, the first time I ever played that game, I cried so hard in the beginning, and I don't know why. It was just very emotional.
Cause you bitch.
Anyway, so I cried. Sorry for all my sniffling. I'm not crying right now, I swear.
Yo, you're not sick anymore. I thought I was going to be sick for a little bit. But yeah, The Break of Us.
The Break of Us.
The Last of Us. They're doing like pre-order sets or whatever the fuck. And they had this one that was almost as much as a PlayStation 4 cost.
Yo, $230. Granted, it did include a lot of stuff. It literally includes a replica of Ellie's backpack with one of the characters, Ellie.
That's true. And a vinyl or something.
And a vinyl and like all this other random bullshit.
Yeah. I mean, it was some cool shit, but I'm not dishing out. I don't like that game that much, you know. Like there's the second pre-order package is actually really cool. It's that shit's still expensive, but I can justify it.
Plus, it comes with like the Ellie figurine, like shit that I would definitely.
I'm more like interested in the bonus is like the extras you get from it. So there's like, you get like different skill sets or like quicker reloading some shit. Like you get perks from the beginning of the game. Yeah, you get like different perks and advantages. So that's pretty cool. That's what I care the most about.
Yeah.
But I definitely want to pre-order that game, so we should do it soon before it sells out.
I would be down. I don't want it to sell out. I'm nervous about that.
It might sell out, to be honest.
Why don't we just pre-order the game?
You'd want the extra shit?
I mean, I do, but
I want to pre-order the game with the things that you can actually get in the game. You know what I mean? I don't care. I don't really mind like the other stuff. I just care about having the.
I want the Ellie figurine.
You can't just buy that?
I probably could.
Get like a pop figure or something.
Yeah, I probably could. Especially like after the game's been out for a month, you know, there's going to be like bullshit merchandise out. So, yeah.
Yeah, there's always a lot of bullshit.
It would be nice to have the in-game extras, though.
Mm-hmm.
Like, just to start out with. Do we have any, like, predictions of what you think is going to happen? So, the description says that, and if you haven't played through The Last of Us, the first one, I don't know if we're going to mention any spoilers, so maybe just don't watch this. Or, I don't know, maybe you don't care. But just warning. There may be some form of like spoilers, but so the description for it basically says that after everything happens in the first one, there's 5 years of peace where they live in that little Wyoming village. I'm guessing the one that Tommy, his brother, was at. They go back there, and then I'm like looking it up. Whatever. And then apparently, like something happens, like something bad happens, and then she goes on to seek revenge and take down every last person that was involved in that event that happens. And a lot of the themes are going to be like, you know, like what really is like a hero or a villain, like good versus evil, like, and not just like good versus evil, like Batman versus like something else, like good versus evil, like what is your definition of good and evil? You know, like it's going to make you question good versus evil. And then like moral, like your morality, like what's moral and what's not moral and things like that.
Moral and immoral. So, what's right, what's wrong?
What do you think? Yeah, what's right, what's wrong? So what do you think, like, do you have any theories on what the like event that like disrupts everything could be?
Probably someone's going to fuck up and the town's going to be overran. Either that or the leaders are going to clash.
Mm.
I feel like Joel's going to die.
Yeah, Joel's probably going to die in this one.
He's definitely going to die.
Because it seems like a lot of this one is from Ellie's perspective, which means that Joel's probably going to die. So Joel's going to die, and that's who she's going to be seeking revenge for, you think?
I think so. I think that's going to break her heart.
Probably.
I feel like, or maybe, because it looks like she has a love interest.
Yeah.
Oh, but in the screenshots, they're together, like, a lot. So maybe she doesn't die.
Well, I don't know. Maybe, like, the village gets overrun, and they have to, like, leave, and then...
Maybe her and Joel split up because of that?
And then she does die or something like that. I don't know. I'm not sure. I wonder how it's going to end.
But the village is definitely going to be overrun.
Yeah, absolutely.
How it's going to end, I think Ellie's going to... I think there's going to be a part three.
I hope so.
There has to be. Yeah. It's funny because part two hasn't even came out.
I know, right? We're like, I hope there's a part three.
But I think that Ellie's going to eventually find her way. And then she's going to be on a quest to look for another civilization to create one or something.
Yeah, maybe. I think that another thing I'm interested in is, like, so in the first one, we get to see what happens to the zombies that exist after 20 years, like how they develop. And there's, like, the bloaters, which are, like, the huge ones that have obviously been sick for a while. And they're, like, you know, in subways and places that they haven't been killed yet.
Like, they're going to mutate or something?
Yeah, like, is there going to be some other mutation that comes along, you know, like...
Wow, the evolution of zombies.
Yeah, like, I'd be interested to see, because I feel like a lot of zombie games, you don't ever see the evolution of zombies. There's, like, one zombie, and that's, like, the zombie of the game, if that makes sense. But then in The Last of Us, there was a very clear, like, they really spent time thinking about what really would happen after 20 years of a zombie apocalypse. Like, would the zombies, like, especially because this is, like, a virus, like, a fungal, like, infection kind of deal. Mm-hmm. Like, what would happen, you know, I don't know.
Like, zombies. Down the line.
Yeah. And then another thing I'm interested in is that the first one, you thought the entire game that, like, your goal was a cure. And then it turns out that your goal was just to replace your daughter. Just kidding. That's not really what it was. But, you know, you question, like, who's right and wrong in the situation. Like, I was very uncomfortable with the ending the first time that I watched it. And I felt awful because I was like, you just lied to Ellie. You know, she knows it. You can see in her eyes that she knows it.
Yeah.
And the game turns out to be less about the zombies and more about, like, the people and the storyline there. Mm. So I'm wondering if there's going to be any revisiting to the search for a cure.
You know what's cool about, I think, wasn't like something about Ellie that she would be kind of the cure because she was immune to it?
That was the whole point of the game, yeah. Is that you're smuggling Ellie and she's immune.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But then at the very end in the hospital, when Joel finds out that she would be killed to get the stuff off the brain, because it was on her brain or I don't know, they had some technical terms. Mm. And he decides, fuck that, I'm going to grab her and get the fuck out of here. And then he lied to her and told her that. So I was a little confused actually about the ending because, okay, so from my perspective, he lies to her and he says, you know, turns out there's plenty of people like you. And none of the surgeries have been
successful.
And they've stopped searching for a cure. And so you're kind of like, well, that's fucking, you're lying. But then it turns out that there's more tape recorders in the game. In that last level, there's like tape recorders where you hear the doctors talking about like the search for a cure. And apparently there's one, and in it, it does talk about how there's been multiple people who've been immune. And every time... they die trying to extract the thing, and then the thing that they extract doesn't even work. So in a way, like, is he really lying? I mean, they're still searching for a cure, so that's a lie. But there have been many people, and they still haven't been able to find a cure.
So it was like a half lie.
It was like a half lie, yeah. And therefore, is it really that bad? Like, I don't really think, personally, that he was wrong in what he did. I would feel the same way.
Yeah, I think when we played the game, I don't remember hearing a doctor say that, which is interesting.
Because I don't think we found that tape recorder.
Yeah, so I feel like people that found those tape recorders, they were like, oh, fuck, like, he didn't lie.
Yeah.
Which is kind of cool because it kind of made that a little better for us, but it also makes it better for other people that did find the tapes.
Yeah, true.
Because for us, like, oh, fuck. Like, yo, he's lying. He's like,
yeah. You know, fuck, my boy lying.
Like, he really cares about her enough to be like, no, fuck that. I'm going to save you. They were lying to you, blah, blah. But then other people were like, oh, shit. He like, actually knows that there's more people and this and that. Yeah. So he really didn't lie to her. So, like, to us, he seemed like kind of like, like, in a way, like, bad guy, but good guy in a way. But to other people, it was like, he did this for a good reason because there are more people out there. And Ellie's going to die, and he cares about her.
I kind of like the perspective that we got because it leaves you with a lot more, like, questions. Like,
more drama.
Questioning, more drama.
More drama.
And it also, like, I don't know, it just makes you think, like, is Joel really a good guy? Or is he, like, bad? Mm-hmm. Like, is he, because he also kills Marlene at the end. Like, he shoots her in the head, which is, like, kind of fucked up. I mean, like, he was like, you'd just come after her, and then he shoots her, which, like, I get it, she probably would just come after her.
Yeah, very true.
But at the same time, I don't know, I just feel like that's so fucked up. I don't know.
Yeah, it is what it
is. So many thoughts about that game, so many feelings. And also, one thing that I think Joel is justified in is that, like, so right before they make it to the hospital at the end where they find the fireflies finally, like, Ellie isn't even awake for that because the thing with the bus happens where they're going through the tunnel to get to the hospital where the fireflies are. Mm-hmm. And the thing where Joel gets stuck in that bus that moves while they're trying to cross it, and she tries to help them, but then the bus moves more. So she falls in the water and he has to kind of drag her through the water. And by the time he takes her out of the water, she's unconscious and he's trying to, like, do CPR and stuff. And these soldiers come up and are like, hey man. And then it turns out that they save them and take them to the fireflies. But, like, I'm like, it doesn't sound like they told Ellie or like she was even conscious to make the decision on whether or not she wanted to go under for the surgery and actually have, like, they didn't tell her, hey, you're going to die, but you could die for a cure. Mm-hmm. So if you want to do this, it would help everybody. If you don't, we'll understand. Like, they should have given her an option. Maybe she would have done it, you know? Like, you never know, but they just were like, fuck that. We're just going to fucking do it. We're just going to kill this bitch without even, like, giving her the option.
Yeah, so with that, you kind of put fate in Joel's hands, in a way.
Exactly, because he felt, you know,
that was fucked up. Yeah, when you put fate in the hands of someone that really loves this person, like, or cares about this person.
Yeah.
Like, shit's going to go south for you, you know? So it's kind of like, I should have thought that shit out more.
Yeah.
Fucking brutos. Say no.
Estúpido. I know what that means.
Bruto means like, well, bruto actually in Italian, I think it means like ugly.
Oh, you know what I saw today?
What?
Somebody was like, can you explain French to me? And someone was like, learn Spanish, then learn Italian, then subtract the Spanish from the Italian and you have French.
That's kind of true, I guess. That's funny as shit. I need to learn Italian. That'd be sick.
You should
learn Italian. Imagine if I was trilingual. That'd be sick.
That would be sick. Yo, my kids are going to be trilingual. Our kids, I should say. Sorry.
I hope so.
We're breaking up.
I hope so. Talking about trilingual, we did the Spotify rap thing, and we're actually pretty big in Germany. So shout out to Germany.
Yo, my Germany kings.
My Joymans.
I don't want to say anything offensive.
No, let's not say anything offensive. But shout out to all my...
I'm German.
Deutschland ist wunderbar.
Yeah. You know? Du bist hässlich.
No.
Yeah, sorry. I just called them ugly.
Yeah, don't do that.
Du bist schon...
Kinderwater.
What is that even?
No, Kinderwater.
Children?
Kinderwater.
Children water?
Yeah, children water.
That's disturbing.
Yeah.
Kinderwater. Well, shout out Germany. I am partially German.
Ich liebe Wasser.
Well, I'm white, but apparently in my history, my ancestors have been German and English mostly. So there you go. Fun fact for you. I'm white.
Deutschland wunderbar. Ich liebe Wasser.
Deutschland, wonderful. I love water.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's true.
Ich spiele Tennis.
You say ich spiele?
Ich spiele.
I thought it was ich liebe.
No, I'm not saying love.
Oh.
I'm saying something else, idiot.
I play tennis?
Yeah.
Ich
spiele Tennis.
Ich spiele PS4.
Mein Kampf.
Oh, no.
All that means is my struggle.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
Nein. What else can I say in German? I think. Oh no, that's Spanish. What the fuck?
What the fuck is wrong with you?
I don't know. Donde? Donde reminds me of German for some reason.
Oh, donde?
So I was gonna say, where's the bathroom? But then I was like,
do you know how to say that in Spanish?
Yeah, donde está el baño?
Wow.
I went to Mexico.
Okay. All right.
Actually, I have a very vivid memory.
That's like saying I have a black friend so I can say the N-word. So
it's not the same at all.
It's not.
I went on vacation to Mexico in like a resort like when I was like 9.
So
10.
You went to and, vacation at a resort.
Yeah, basically. But it was technically a resort in Mexico. And we did leave the resort to go see some like ruins.
Wow.
But I was 9 or 10, so I literally don't even remember anything about it.
Yep.
Excuse me.
Nice.
I remember 3 things. I remember the iguanas, because they were huge and everywhere, and they weren't that scared of you. And then I remember there was a swim-up bar, and I had a virgin pina colada.
Wow.
And I also remember I was in a shop somewhere, not in the resort, I don't think. I'm not sure where we were. And I said, ¿dónde está el baño? And she started speaking in Spanish to me about where the bathroom was. I was like, whoa.
Wait, how white did you say that?
I have no idea. Pretty sure I just said, ¿dónde está el baño? I don't know if that's white. I have no idea how I said it then. Again, I was 9. I don't remember.
What's the least white you can say that? Least American.
I don't know. How do you say it?
¿Dónde está el baño?
¿Dónde está el baño?
All right, so, ¿dónde?
¿Dónde está el baño?
No, ew.
There's the
I'm
most white.
Fucking throw up.
¿Dónde
right.
está el baño?
¿Dónde?
¿Dónde?
Está.
Está.
El.
El.
Baño.
Baño. I feel like with L, your L's, you're like, say
el.
L.
El.
Yeah, it sounds so much less white.
Try it. It's el.
El.
There it is. But,
yeah,
but the thing
but
is, you
I
go
gotta
el.
Focus. I got to focus to do that. I can't just whip that out in the middle of a sentence.
But the thing is, you go el.
El.
Just go el.
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 El baño.
El baño.
Pa.
Pa.
Ño.
Ño.
El baño.
El baño.
I guess the thing is with with people that don't speak Spanish and only English, I feel like they try to accentuate too much. So it sounds like they're trying too hard sometimes.
Really?
Yeah, because it's supposed to be like smooth, like baño, not baño.
Did I say it like that?
Like slightly. But it's not like you can help it. It's the way you're.
I don't accentuate anything. I'm just like.
Yeah, it's just the way your tongue is. I'm not saying that you're trying to.
My tongue sucks.
But it just sounds like that's how it is. Because the way English is spoken, I feel like it's such a. It's not that smooth of a language.
Yeah.
It's not a stop and start.
Yeah, it's not that smooth. It's not. It's also not the harshest language.
Yeah, it's not. It's not the harshest language, but it's not the smooth.
But it's definitely not smooth.
Yeah. Like with Spanish.
Oh my God.
Sometimes my mouth gets tired when I speak
Spanish
for too long.
There's that great. Video on YouTube of what it sounds like, of what English sounds like to somebody who doesn't speak English. It's so weird. Wait, I gotta fucking find this shit. Hold on. Just start talking to them. I'm gonna look it up.
Wait, you said it's on YouTube? I can look it up.
Yeah, it's like what English sounds like to non-English speakers or something like that. It's like a couple and they're like talking.
What English?
Oh, to foreigners.
This
yeah, 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 yeah.
Hopefully we don't get taken off YouTube because of this.
Why would we?
Because it's not our content. I don't know. Oh, it's not playing.
Oh, no.
Okay, here we go. Oh, you son of a bitch.
What?
No, it's not playing.
No. Oh, all right. Well, let me find it on YouTube then.
Well, there's that. So that's cool. Well, it's playing. It's just no sounds coming
out.
Well,
right.
But
this is such a... It's so interesting. And I'll just let you know first that this is by a YouTube channel called Brian and Carl. Carl spelled with a K. I don't know if they made, let's see if there's any credits under it or something. It's a short film in fake English. Squirrel is what it's called. SKWERL. But the directed by Brian. Oh yeah. So it is made by Brian and Carl. All right. So let me play it. Hold on, I turn up my volume. Des ailes sur les dunes. Well, that's just music.
Well, that's just music. Oh, wait, I know. Wait. I know why it wasn't playing. There it is. Oh. So Bluetooth is connected. Oh,
stupid.
Here's Lace. We made a lot of them.
Sure.
Oh, that's interesting.
I bought you like 5 rounds of eggs with coordination.
Sounds good.
That's so weird.
Yeah, isn't it kind of freaky?
Like, so I ran to Yorker on the watch today.
Oh?
Yeah. That doll's a rainbow on her face. Can't brave that more Elton John.
He said can't brave more Elton John.
Is that by the love that call?
Yeah, I come by the next ring. I played that Pribadium by the wrong front line today.
Oh, the rainbow.
It's like I can just barely hear them say real things, yeah. But it sounds so fucking weird. It's like,
I guess awful. I guess I can kind of relate to that. When I hear like Portuguese being spoken or Italian,
because
like every now and then you can hear one word that you can pick out, but like with
yeah, that's how I feel with Spanish now.
Yeah, like
I hear words and I'm like, oh, I know that word.
Yeah, like sometimes like when I hear Portuguese or Italian, like Italian I can understand a little bit more than Portuguese, because Portuguese it sounds like it's like what language do people speak in Sweden? I'm an
Swedish.
Idiot. Swedish. It kind of sounds like that, but then every now and then there's like a Spanish word being thrown in.
Oh, so it's like a weird Swedish Spanish.
Yeah, because they use their throat a lot. They go like, ooh.
Ew, wait. Do look up Portuguese. I want to hear what Portuguese sounds like. What do you think is the I know a little bit about like the Asian languages, and just like the three most popular ones that I know about are like Chinese, Japanese, and Korean. I feel a little bit confident that I can maybe pick them out from each other, just from like hearing about them.
Alemão? Você fala alemão?
Você fala alemão?
Yeah, well, he sounds funny. You know,
it's like they use their throat a lot. Você fala alemão? Like it's weird.
Yeah, that is kind of weird.
I mean, it's not weird, but it's like, you know, it's
what does Italian sound like?
Italian. Você fala alemão?
What does that mean? Oh, do you speak German? Weird.
Learn Italian in 30 minutes.
Want more Italian videos like
this? Yes.
Hi, I'm Consuelo. Nice to meet you.
Ciao.
Sono Consuelo. Piacere di conoscerti.
All right, so this in Spanish, you would be like, hi, what the fuck? This in Spanish would be, hola, soy Consuelo. Gusto a conocerte.
So it's a little similar, conocerte and sono, conocerte. Or you said soy, yeah. But and then Consuelo.
No. Oh yeah, hola, soy, yeah, Consuelo, gusto, so piacere, I would not know what that is.
Piacere.
Like, at all.
That's really pretty.
So, but it's like gusto, like piacere, and then di conocerti, whatever.
I wonder where the Spanish that you know and Italian and Spanish, like how did all these languages like that are so similar to each other, like where did they come from? Like, I don't know. How did they, like, was, I don't know.
They all derive from Latin, right?
I guess. I don't know.
That's crazy. Imagine like, all right, so say everyone like spoke Spanish, I mean Latin at one point. Like, then they spread out, and then people were like, let's make our own language.
But like, I don't know. The there's also a lot of other different, like, not everything came from Latin.
Like, oh, you're right. That's
like,
true.
Like, there's Old English, which looks crazy. And, so I don't think everything came from Latin, but I think maybe those just, countries came from Latin.
It's just crazy how language derived, like, how
it is. Also,
like, out of nowhere.
The history of Guatemala. So the people that are living there now. Like, okay, so you know how there were Native people living in America, and obviously people invaded it and kind of weeded those people out, although there are still some of them that are native to here. Mm. But, like, Guatemala, are the people living there, were they always there, or did they come from somewhere else
and
settle
sure.
there? Like, was there, like, because I know that a lot, like, Spain invaded a lot of that area and discovered a lot of that area. in like the 1600s, right? But did they? Oh, Guatemala country. The dominance of an Indian culture with its interior uplands.
Indian. Derivation and meaning are undetermined. What is the origin?
Who first settled in Guatemala? Is a question there. The Mayan civilization was already somewhat fragmented when Europeans arrived in the 1500s, and on the weakened divided Mayan were easily conquered by the Spaniards. Okay, so Mayan and Spaniard, I'm guessing, is like the background of most people that live there today, then?
I guess.
Because, yeah, because the Spaniards
invaded. I always thought it was like African or something, but I guess not.
Like the people that were living, well, why were, like Africans invaded?
That's what I thought. I thought Africans were there, but I guess not.
Well, definitely Spaniards, because that's like part of history is that Spain was in like settling a lot of that area. I should have known Mayans. Duh.
Yeah, 55% indigenous and 45% Latina, Spanish speaking. 20 languages are spoken, although dominant language is Spanish. The main ethnic groups are Maya, the Garifuna, the Inca, and the Ladina.
I wonder where your family.
I think my family is like their background is like Spanish, like from Spain or really? From Europe. Yeah, because my last name Tovar, it's like very I think that name's pretty big in Spain.
Let me look it up.
I might be wrong, but
you should look. You know, up I can look it up here. Yeah, I don't know. I keep trying to look up things on my phone. You have a laptop right there. I'm so stupid. Tovar last name.
Yeah, Spanish.
Spanish. Yeah, interesting. So.
A kind of light porous volcanic rock.
Yo, we should do ancestry. I feel like it would be interesting. Mine would say white, but still might be cool.
Yeah, I wonder what mine would say. I'm just afraid to give like a company my DNA.
I know, me too, but other I still than, like, am the doctor's super office. Curious.
Yeah, I'm like.
So I wish. So apparently I'm English and German. That's like two things that I do know about myself. However, the last name Cook is not my blood name because my father's
Lothrop
father's father, my dad's grandfather. Yeah, Lothrop's the other one. And Perry, because that's my grandmother on my dad's side last name. So the Cook, my dad's grandfather basically was an orphan and they kind of took him up from the streets. They had no idea who his parents were, and I don't think he even knows. So Cook isn't his last name. So Cook, I don't think I can use that and say like, oh, well, let me look in the history of Cook and see, you know. But yeah, Perry is English, and then Lothrop is also, I believe, English. East Yorkshire.
Yorkshire.
It's borrowed from the name Lothorp in East Yorkshire. Habitual name from East with the Old Norse personal name Logi, or which means outlying farmstead. So my ancestors were farmers.
Wow. My ancestors were volcanic rocks. I'm way cooler.
Where the fuck is East Yorkshire?
Fucking burn you, bro.
Okay, so England. Yeah, English. Northern England. So wow, I'm just fucking English and that's it. No, but also on my mom's side is German because her... I don't know. Oh, what's my grandmother's maiden name? Man.
Beats my ass. I don't
fucking know. Beats my ass, too.
Beats my ass. Horde.
I don't know. I should ask my mom next time I see her. Yeah, but I think they're German. And I think that they think that my dad's family is German. They don't actually know where he comes from, but they think that he's German. So, yeah. Fun fact. Yeah. So, in other words... I'm white.
Good one. Yeah. I like
just
that.
Just kidding.
Yeah.
Let me try again. I'm white.
I don't like that.
Sorry.
I am the governor of California. Okay, that was bad.
What the fuck was that?
Yeah, get to the chopper.
Why is he? Why is it? Yeah. Why do you? Yeah.
Like, get to the chopper. I don't know. That's so. Like that? It's just like an obnoxious impression of the California governor, state governor.
Oh my god! Wow, it's already been an hour, dude. Talking about history and like language and like stuff like that. That shit's interesting. Time goes by really fast.
Yeah, for the three people listening. thanks for sticking around.
Thanks for sticking around, guys.
Everyone's like, oh, here we go. Language again. And then they fucking left.
We should make this a language podcast. Ew. We've already had two episodes where we go heavily into like language and history and shit.
Yeah, very true.
No, are we nerds?
We're fucking, I know no, I'm a nerd, bro.
Fuck, am I a nerd? Fuck.
We talked about The Last
am
of
I
Us.
Am I a fucking nerd?
Dude, I'm a nerd hardcore. I still have a bunch of topics we didn't
speaking
get on.
Speaking of being a nerd.
What?
I have a physics test tomorrow at 9 a.m.
Gross.
And I have like 3 hours until I start to feel tired and like I don't want to do it anymore.
Damn, it's 7 already?
Yeah, it's 7. And I'm fucking hungry.
Yeah, I'm about to go make some food right now.
Yeah.
Because, you know, I'm the cook in the family, you feel me? Sorry.
My last name's Cook, so technically I'm the cook in the family. But, you know. Will our kids take your last name?
It sounds cooler.
When we get married, should I take your last name? It does sound cooler.
That's up to you, bro. I'm not going to tell you to do anything.
Should I be Cook Tovar? I feel like anyone that sees my last name or my name, Anna Tovar, they're going to immediately think I'm Spanish.
Yeah, because Anna's a pretty Spanish name. Yeah. Anna Tovar.
Yeah.
Anna Cook.
Weird.
Yeah, anyway. just reflecting on our life. Like,
all right.
Like, fuck kids, no sleep, gut, 30 years old.
What? Is that what's going to happen in another
I hope not.
6 years?
I want to be a healthy dad that can run around with my kids.
You're going to be 6 years. You're going to be 6 years old.
Well, I'm going to go back in time. You got that Benjamin Buttons.
So. In 6 years, you will be 30. In 9 years, you will be 30.
Oh my God, shut up, dude. I don't care. I'm going to be 33, but I'm still going to look 26. I guarantee that.
In 10 years, you're going to be 34.
Wait, how old am I right now?
24. What the fuck do you mean? I just said I'm about to be 6 years.
I'm about to be 25.
Yeah, you fucking old bitch.
Yo, my birthday is, what's today, the 10th?
18 days.
My birthday's in 18 days, bro.
Yo, that's crazy.
That's dirty as fuck.
That is dirty as fuck. You're about to be 25.
Nah, man.
You're about to be an old man.
I forget how old I am. I don't know if you guys do the same thing, but I always forget how old I am.
I don't know how that's possible.
I'm like...
I want to forget how old I am. Dude, fun and games when you're 21, 22, but then all of a sudden, you're 24 and it's like, am I an adult? I don't know. It's just going to get worse from here.
I'm still a kid. I'm young.
Like, I feel like when I was... like 19, I was like, all right, I feel kind of older, but like I still have years ahead of me where I'm gonna feel young. But now I'm starting to get to the point where like my late 20s are right around the corner, and like I'm gonna start feeling like I'm getting old.
Damn, you gotta start taking care of ourselves.
You've been through a whole quarter of your life.
Yeah,
you're
going
to have to do it three more times.
But imagine, like, there's some people that have lived twice as long as us.
That's true. But you got, like, let's say you're going to live to 100. I'm assuming that most of the people our age are going to live to 100 unless there's some kind of crazy accident, because that's the way health and stuff is going nowadays. If you live to 100, you've officially lived through a whole quarter of your life, and you're going to have to do this three more times. You have to live all of the life that you just lived three more times. All of that time, you have to do three more times. Yeah, and every time, it's going to go by faster and faster.
It's happening faster, so you're probably not going to feel it.
Well, that's still sad. It's crazy how when you were young, you know, we can't start talking about this.
It's crazy that we all have a chance to die. I'm just going to leave it off on that.
Yo, what the fuck kind of ending comment is that?
Like, I think that I'm never going to die, and I'm like, wait, fuck, one of these days, I'm going
to
die.
You're literally going
to
die.
Like, this shit can happen to me, too. Like, it's crazy.
You know what also fucks me up is that, what? Like, especially, like, if we're talking about relationship-wise, one of us is going to die before the other one.
All right.
And, like, that's trash. Also, your parents are going to die before you die.
All right.
And, like, your siblings... somebody's going to die before you do, or like you might die before. Like that's fucked up. Don't think about it too hard. Stop looking off in the distance and thinking.
It is fucked up. Anyway, so let's end this on a positive note, guys. The holidays are coming up, and, you know, I recently received a bonus from my job. So shout out to my place of occupation.
We're going to be going out to dinner.
Yeah, it came up a lot of money. Buys a lot of nitrous.
Buys a lot of nitrous. Parks
and
Rec reference.
There's that. And I hope all of you guys are out there getting bonuses for the holidays, or, you know, you're going to be receiving great gifts or giving great gifts. To me, I love giving gifts. Or it's better than receiving.
Yeah, hell yeah. Or spending time with your family.
Oh, yeah. You know, just, you know, end it on a positive note. You know, be out there with your family. Do good shit.
Eat some Christmas goose.
Eat some Christmas goose. And wow, what the fuck does that mean?
I don't know.
Eat some grapes and some marshmallows, you know.
Yeah.
We're definitely going to be probably doing a Christmas episode. We're probably going to do it like early ahead of time. And because I think next week, Anna won't be able to do the podcast.
Definitely not. It's going to be a bad time. Final season, boy.
So I might drop a bonus episode either with Gerardo or, you know, if Anna can sneak one in with me because she's always doing something.
Maybe. We'll see.
So expect to have Gerardo back on here, and you know, him and I are going to go to Sixers game soon. So it's going to be a lot of fun. Anyways,
this is a long outro.
It is a long outro.
Thanks for staying with us even through the bullshit this episode.
Good times and bad times and good times and bad times. Anyway, we love y'all. Anna, where can they find you?
Anna Can't Cook, Instagram. And Piper plus Willow, my cat.
And you can find me at gilmar.tobar on Instagram. And also follow the podcast on Instagram at Firm Earth Podcast. And find us everywhere. Tell your mom about it. Tell your sisters about it. To all the new people listening, welcome.
Tell your boo.
I'm saying welcome at the end of the episode, but welcome. Thank you for watching and tell everyone else about it. And we love y'all. And
thanks, Germany.
And we'll keep posting new shit on the Instagram because a lot of people will like it and it gets received really well. So,
woo!
Love y'all. Goodbye.
Bye.